IceJade, Gymir, Aegirine. So this card was one of the more interesting ultras to come out of Photon Hypernova, the recent Yu-Gi-Oh set. And I gotta say, personally, while it isn't the most splashable tech card, this card I do feel like will actually be a staple in certain rogue decks, especially water-based decks, because as you can see, it takes a water tuner in order to make this. Not the hardest thing, but it certainly isn't gonna be splashable like the first episode, where we talked about time theft for Dura. Now I understand I got some crap in the comments of that one where I pronounced it theft when it's thief, and I certainly make no promises that I'm gonna pronounce this card properly, as I probably already have mispronounced it. But you gotta understand, tomato tomato. Also keep in mind that a lot of these words for the names nowadays are made up, so the pronunciation is usually debatable, but typically what ends up happening is usually someone from the community and or Konami pronounces it. Then that's usually the standard on how you would pronounce such a card name. That and theft just honestly sounds cooler. Well, anyways, getting back to this particular IceJade monster. This IceJade monster comes with a particularly interesting effect, as we live in a format where Raigeki is at 3, Dark Hole is at 3, but no one runs them because most decks have an out to general destruction. But I am getting ahead of myself, so let's read this card's effect. One water tuner, one or more non-tuner monsters. Quick effect. You can activate this effect. Semicolon. Face-up monsters you control cannot be destroyed by battle or banished by your opponent card effects this turn. Then, if you activated this effect in response to your opponent's card or effect activation, and your opponent has cards with that name on their field or in the graveyard, you can banish those cards. If a card is banished by your opponent's card effect while this card is in your graveyard, except during the damage step, of course, colon, you can special summon this card. You can only use each effect of Gymir Aegirine once per turn. Now, immediately we have an effect that is able to be activated during each player's turn, because that's how quick effects work, to basically just shut down any sort of destruction by card effect, so Raigeki and Dark Hole, or even banishment, which the Sky Striker Link card is very well known to do so. But wait, there's more! Just the thought of being able to banish whatever you chain this against to literally encourages you to use its effect when your opponent uses something against you. It's great. You could literally use this card mid-combo during your opponent's turn and potentially shut them down and prevent your cards from being both banished or destroyed at the same time. Of course, if they don't try to bait that with like a lightning storm or something. But either way, you are still gaining an ability to basically shut that lightning storm down and forcing them to use another key card to get rid of it. And speaking of key cards, this card does actually have some ways around some of the more current staples that you'll see in the current meta. Bystal Druidswarm is a great example. Now, you would think Bystal Druidswarm, because it sends a card to the graveyard when it gets sent from the field to the graveyard, that it would automatically just sort of cancel out the fact that you can negate banishment or destruction. But the thing is, while they may be able to send the card to the graveyard, that's not before you'll be able to chain its effect by basically banishing it from the graveyard. What's even better is that because you banished it from the graveyard the moment that it activated its effect to send IceJade to the graveyard, it actually won't go through because you banished it from where its effect is supposed to be activated. And any card that activates in one spot and gets moved to another in the middle of a chain link, the effect to send a special summon monster to the graveyard will not resolve, as per the new master rules introduced in 2020. Considering its pseudo called by the grave kind of effect we got going on here, this card can sometimes introduce certain options or outs depending on the scenario. Also, if going first, this card really can help with certain trap tricks matchups, as you'll be able to negate a good chunk of the trap hole support, as a lot of the trap hole cards, especially bottomless trap hole, do destroy. So you too can go to your locals and tell a trap tricks player to shove their mantis up their trap hole. Yeah, you know what, now that I think about it, some of them will probably enjoy that, the fucking creeps. But talking about Yu-Gi-Oh! Degenerates is for another segment entirely. Now, while we're still on the subject of trap tricks, and I know I'm gonna pronounce this card wrong, this card could also potentially be used against trap tricks Itapus? Itapus? Again, made up words. So don't get mad about the mispronunciation. But yeah, if this card targets it before IceJade has gone off for the turn, you could potentially counter this. Okay, let's talk about some of the decks that can make this card. Again, anything that includes water tuners. So Mermels could definitely make this card. And with Deep Sea Diva at 3 these days, I could definitely see them pulling this card off relatively easy. If anybody plays Crystrons these days, of course without the Needle Fiber, then they're all water, and most of them are tuners. I'd like to say Dynamis could use it too, but I don't think they have any tuners. So unless you're gonna tech in Deep Sea Diva, I'm not seeing it. Interestingly enough, a water tuner that's pretty generic goes to one of my favorite decks, Crusadius. That's right, Aboria is a tuner, and it is water attribute. So guess what that means? You can Sangan combo your way into this card if you want to pull off the Sangan X Salomon Great Almirjazz. Again, these are made up words. Don't get triggered. Combo that allows you to basically get Aboria in your hand, and because Aboria's effect does not activate, Sangan does not prevent it from being able to special summon itself under an unused monster zone a Link Arrow is pointing to, essentially allowing you to search for the water tuner that you would need to get this IceJade card out. Also a bonus that it's a level 3 tuner, as you can literally get this out with one Aboria and a level 7. Now I will bring up one more water-based deck, solely just for a shout out to the guy at my locals that really loves it, Umi Control. Now I can't really see Umi Control running synchros, as they basically just want to summon the jellyfish to get the sea leviathan out to basically prevent you from summoning anything but waters. But if you could fit it, what better way to control your opponent by basically controlling what they can destroy and banish and whatnot, along with the pseudo called by the grave effect we got going here. Now, of course, you could also throw this in the IceJade deck itself, but the funny thing is that this is definitely one of those cards that works better in other better decks than the deck it was originally made for. Not an uncommon trait amongst Yu-Gi-Oh cards, to be honest. It was the same with Time Theft Redoer. Just generically good extra deck cards, regardless of their namesake, are always worth considering. The last nice thing about this card for sure is the fact that if your opponent banishes stuff on your side of the field and this card's in the graveyard, it can resurrect itself. The only thing I see going against that would simply be something like D Fisher or Macrocosmos that literally prevents your graveyard from being used in most circumstances. So a Synchro 10 that basically allows you to chain, make all your monsters impervious to both destruction and banishment, allowing you to get rid of certain key cards even if you can't quite negate them, makes this card worth running. The only thing you have to get around is that whole condition of having a water tuner. It's not impossible, but it certainly makes this tech choice a little more rogue than what I would typically cover in this segment, but I feel like its qualifications and its price point and the way most people are viewing it at the moment allows this card to be qualified as secretly OP.